how to set up Google Analytics in WordPress. Google Analytics is one of the best tools at your disposal for learning more about who your website visitors are, where they come from, and what they were looking for when they arrived on your site. It's an invaluable tool for determining what kind of content to focus on publishing on your blog. And best of all, it's completely free. In many ways, it's even easier to set up Google Analytics in WordPress site than a hand-coded website. Because you can use a plugin, there is no need to mess with your website's code. And once it's configured properly, you can pretty much just forget it's even there. You can also set up goals in Google Analytics, such as file downloads, newsletter signups, or product sales, then measure your site's performance against those goals. Armed with all this data, you can then start working on optimizing your website for better results. The first thing you need to do in order to take advantage of this tool is to create a Google Analytics property for your website. If you do not yet have a Google Analytics account, you'll create the property during the sign-up process. Go to the Google Analytics homepage and click Sign Up. Log in with your Google account, and from there you'll be taken to an account setup screen. For your account name, you can use your name or your company name. You can track multiple websites on the same account, which makes things easier if you own a number of different websites. Then, you fill out the details for your new property, which is the website you would like to track. Enter your website's name, URL, industry, time zone, and click Get Tracking ID. After you accept the terms and conditions, you'll be taken to a screen where you'll see your tracking ID, a string of numbers beginning with the letters UA. Hold on to this ID as you continue to follow the steps to set up Google Analytics in WordPress. For the next step, you'll need to install a plugin that will automatically add the tracking code to your site for you. I recommend the plugin Google Analytics by Monster Insights, because it's the most popular and most actively maintained plugin of this type. To add it to your site, search for it by name under Plugins, Add New. When you find the right plugin, click the Install Now button. WordPress will go through the process of installing the plugin. When it's done, click Activate the plugin to turn it on. This is the third step. And now that you've installed and activated the Google Analytics plugin, you need to configure it so that it will communicate with your Google Analytics account. You can do this by clicking its settings link on the plugins page. Or you can go through the left-hand menu bar and navigate to Insights and Settings. From the main page of the plugin settings, click the button that says Authenticate with your Google account. This will display a pop-up window asking for permission to connect to your Google account. Click Allow. On the next screen, you will see a long string of random characters. Copy and paste this code into the highlighted box back in the WordPress tab. Then, click Save Authentication Code. The settings screen will refresh to include a dropdown. In that dropdown, select the Google Analytics property that you just created. The tracking ID should match the UA code you just created in step 1. Click Save Changes. Congratulations! You officially set up Google Analytics in WordPress. Now, let's test it to make sure it is working correctly. There are a number of ways to test that everything is working properly, but by far the easiest way is to test it in real-time analytics. If you are still on the admin screen in Google Analytics, click Reporting at the top of the screen to go to the section of Google Analytics with tracking data. In the left side menu, click Real-time to expand the submenu, then click Overview. If you want to set up Google Analytics in WordPress for a brand new website, you most likely have zero current visitors, which isn't exactly helpful for trying to tell if your tracking code is working correctly. By default, this plugin does not track visits from logged in administrators or editors. This is a setting I recommend you leave as it is, because tracking your own visits to your site can obscure the data you want. However, it also means that if you try to visit your own website in the same browser, your visits won't be counted. To get around this for testing purposes, open your website in another browser and click through a page or two to register your visit in Google Analytics. If everything is working as it should, immediately after doing this, real-time analytics should show you one visitor on your site. If you still don't see a visitor on your website, try opening your website in another browser, or click the button in the plugin settings to re-authenticate with your Google account to try again. That's it! Now that you've created a Google Analytics property for your website, installed and configured the plugin, and tested it, you can rest assured that you are capturing the data you need about your users and that you have successfully set up Google Analytics in WordPress.